folks, and welcome to our last time of Do
You
Know.
That's right.
It's the last one.
Last one. It's been great.
I feel like I should cry.
No, don't cry. Don't cry. It'll be all right.
Okay.
We got another one coming. More to come on that.
More coming on that at the end of this program. But hey, hadn't it been a great, great series?
It's been a great series, and I've learned a lot.
Have you really?
Yeah, I really have.
Yeah, I've learned.
Some of these things I've not gone over.
Okay.
For a very, very, very long time.
It's been a while.
So it's been good. Good for me.
But it's been good for all of us. Hope it's been good for you, and I hope that you have enjoyed what we're doing. So really what we're going to be doing today is a...
We're going to recap.
A what?
A review.
Recaps. I mean, you take one cap on and take it for another.
Should have brought my hats. I have lots.
You have lots of hats.
I do.
That's right.
Yeah, we're going to recap. We're going to talk about some of the things we've talked about over this series.
And we're going to pull out some of the things that you have seen mm-hmm. over the last 12, 13 weeks. From this and kind of
see if I can jog their memory a little bit.
That's right. In fact, let's go ahead and move to the very, very first one. Can we do that?
Absolutely.
The greatest book in the world, is
the Bible.
The Bible.
Yeah.
You know, the B-I-B-L-E. That's the book for me. And so it is the greatest book in the world. Teaches us everything we need to know.
Yeah.
In fact, let's see if they remember all 66 books found in the Bible.
Okay.
As our teens lead them, okay?
Yeah, sing along.
Genesis.
Exodus.
Leviticus.
Numbers. Deuteronomy. Joshua. Judges.
Ruth.
1st and 2nd Samuel. 1st and 2nd Kings.
1st and 2nd Chronicles.
Ezra.
Nehemiah.
Esther.
Job.
Psalms.
Proverbs.
Ecclesiastes.
Song of Solomon.
Isaiah.
Jeremiah.
Lamentations.
Ezekiel.
Daniel.
Hosea.
Joel.
Amos.
Obadiah.
Jonah.
Micah.
Daniel.
Habakkuk, Zephaniah,
Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi,
Matthew, Mark, Luke, John,
Acts, Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians,
Ephesians, Philippians,
Colossians,
1st and 2nd Thessalonians,
1st and 2nd Timothy,
Titus,
Philemon,
Hebrews,
James,
1st and 2nd Peter,
1st and 2nd and 3rd John,
Jude,
Revelations.
So, you've enjoyed that. You knew. I know everybody knew all 66 books, right?
I bet they did.
From generations to revolutions.
Something like that. I think Mr. Jerry needs to watch it.
Oh, maybe I need to go back and check it out. But then we move to another segment of our thing. We talked about the days of creation.
Uh-huh, and so that's
we talked,
right.
And then we moved into this group that was called the Judges. Yeah.
Yeah. Some interesting names in there.
Yeah, you know, but as always, there's a way to learn them, right?
Yes, there's almost always a song.
There's always, well, according to you, there's a song for everything that we need to know.
It helps us remember.
And it did, and to be honest with you, this does help me remember.
Yeah, because, helps me remember too.
So yeah. let's join in with our kids as they sing the song about the judges.
Okay.
God sent judges over.
We've studied about the judges, and we're going through this Old Testament really, really quick right now.
Yes.
So we did the judges, and now there comes these wonderful group of people called...
Yeah, the prophets.
The prophets.
The prophets of the Old Testament. That's
and
right.
They were people that foretold mm-hmm. stories, mm-hmm. things that were going to happen currently and things that were going
to
happen...
To come.
Hundreds of years down the road.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you know who sings about the prophets, don't you?
Who?
Me and you.
Oh, that's right. We did.
That's us.
That's right. Yeah, we did a great job.
In fact, I we would sing it live right now. No. Let's go back to our video clip and see what we looked at. On the prophets, sing along.
I'm ready.
Let us sing the major prophets, major prophets, major prophets. Let us sing the major prophets, the greatest of them all. Isaiah, Jeremiah, who wrote Lamentations. Ezekiel and Daniel, who were true to their God. Let us sing the minor prophets, minor prophets, minor prophets. Let us sing the minor prophets. There were 12 of them all. Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahumacca, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
We had the prophets
yes.
that come in, and in the Old Testament we were reading about a king. The people were looking for a king, and God anointed
David
to come in, and David gave us one of our most beautiful psalms that we also memorized, which was
Psalm 23.
Yeah. And you know, which, you know, we're going to make a quick transition here going into where we move into the New Testament, right? All right, so that's those 27 books of the New Testament that they heard.
Yes, that they all know.
Everybody knows those 27 books. That's right. And so, but now there's a mission that's kind of found in this. The people go out, Jesus comes in, Jesus works, and he shows people how to live their life. But then he leaves a mission for us, right? He tells us to be a light. A lot of his teaching is for us to be a light to the world.
To go and tell people about Jesus.
Yeah, in fact, that led us to Matthew 28,
verse 19,
and our kids show us a neat little thing about that.
Oh, cool, okay.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Matthew 28, verse 19 and 20.
To be a light. To be a light. Jesus comes in and he chooses some people.
Yes. 12 special people. 12 apostles.
Well, 12 that we sing about.
That 12 that we sing about. That is correct.
There were some more.
There were more.
And I'm going to say,
We need a new song. We need a new song. But anyway,
we did cover the 12 apostles, and we've got a video that covers it. See if they can sing along with us, and can you leave us a comment about the other apostles that are mentioned?
That's right. Okay.
Jesus called them one by one.
Peter, Andrew, James, and John.
Next came Philip, Thomas, too.
Matthew and Bartholomew.
Yes, Jesus called them. Yes, Jesus called them. Yes, Jesus called them. And they all followed him.
James, the one they call the less.
Simon, also Thaddeus.
The 12th apostle Judas made.
Jesus was by him betrayed.
Yes, Jesus called them. Yes, Jesus called them. Yes, Jesus called them. And they all followed him.
The 12 apostles came in, all right? And then we read about the other ones that are there. But there's one special one we read about over in the book of Acts. There was this guy that his name was Saul. And we know him more famously as
Paul.
As Paul, because of everything that happened in his life and how he turned his life around. Now, one of the unique things that Paul does, Paul is one of our famous
writers. Right. He wrote most of the New Testament.
That's correct.
Right.
Right, most of the New Testament, and we have a lot of really neat things about it. But he gives us one of the most famous things in telling us how to live our life, called the
Fruit of the Spirit.
The Fruit of the Spirit.
Which is a fun song.
It is a fun song, and guess what?
Yes.
Our kids are going to sing about this song,
sing about it
right now. So enjoy it.
The Fruit of the Spirit is not a coconut. The Fruit of the Spirit is not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit of death, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
We learned about the fruit of the Spirit, right?
Know the fruit of the Spirit. That's right.
All of this fits into a neat, neat package. It fits into a neat, neat picture. So why God loves us. Why God loves us. God does every bit of this from the Old Testament, following us all the way through. And he falls into and telling us why he even sends his son in John
3:16.
3:16. And our kids actually, this was this actually was one of my favorite ones.
Was it?
Because, you know, this is the one we opened up with she signing.
Yes.
Yes.
I love that.
Ashley did a great job of signing John 3:16, and everybody was kind of like, what's she doing at the very beginning? And our kids did a great job with a little mashup of John 3:16. And so enjoy watching John 3:16.
For God so loved the world, so loved the world that he gave
his only begotten Son.
His only begotten Son.
That whoever
believed in him
shall not perish.
And will not perish.
But have everlasting life.
But have everlasting life.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son. So everyone who believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Well, folks, this is the end of my show, end of the career. I'm Bob Sunshine, this is the Ultimate Trivia Show. That's Phil, that's Millie. They're now billionaires.
This is the best day of my life.
That makes two of us.
I'm supposed to ask you some questions on this Ultimate Trivia Show, but frankly, I'm in the hole so far already. I don't want to waste any more of my money. I don't want you to win any more of my money. I'm done.
Oh, come on, Bob. Come on, quiz us.
No. I'd rather just the clock tick down on my career and be done with it.
Fine. We'll just quiz ourselves then.
All right, that sounds like fun.
Okay. What's first book of the Bible?
First book. Hey, Revelations.
It's Genesis.
Oh, oops.
Good job, Bob. Good job. I'm proud of you there. Okay, next. What's the two halves of a Bible?
All right, red half and the blue half.
The Old Testament and the New Testament.
Okay. That's right. You're doing good there now. So name me three judges from the Bible.
All right. Judge Judy and Judge Wapner.
Oh me. Deborah, Gideon, Jephthah.
He's right again, folks. That's right.
All right. Let me ask him one. All right, I'm going to ask him. What were the first three kings of Israel?
Saul, David, and Solomon.
Okay. What about two minor prophets?
Micah and Malachi.
Three disciples of Jesus?
Simon the Zealot, Matthew, and Judas.
Okay. Who was the enemy of Jesus who became a leader in the new church?
Saul, who became Paul.
All right. Why did Jesus die?
To save us from our sins.
All right. Last book of the Bible?
The book of Revelation.
Amazing!
He is a genius.
He's just flat out perfect.
Uh-huh. Yep. All right, Bob. We have good news for you. Good news. You gave so much money away today. The producers, they're going to sell the show.
How is that good news?
Because we done bought the show. And because you're so smart with all this trivia,
we want you to be the host!
Yes!
Really?
Yes!
Well, I guess this isn't the end of my career after all, but it is the end of my show. I'm Bob Sunshine, and this has been the Ultimate Trivia Show.
So you saw a funny skit.
Yes.
Like you haven't seen one already this time. In this time. And we appreciate Mr. Dale with everything that he's done as far as teaching Bible classes and things like that for this whole quarter. It's kind of got him out of some of his comfort zone. It is his comfort zone. He just doesn't realize
that. It is. And he's always willing to help.
Absolutely.
So I'm very thankful
for that. Well, okay, so we've memorized all of these things. All right, all these things we've committed to our memory so that we can know these things.
Yes. That's right.
So we can know these things that we're talking about. One of the things that I think that is very, very important for us and all is how we can communicate with God. And Jesus showed us the perfect way.
Mm-hmm.
by having prayer. Mm-hmm. You know, we read what God wants us to do from the Word of God. But Jesus was asked, you know, a question, you know, how do we pray? Mm-hmm. How do we pray? And he offered in the Lord's Prayer. And that's when he said, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Jesus in that prayer encompasses everything that we need to know in talking to God. And that's exactly what it is, a conversation to God the Father. So I hope that they will memorize that prayer to help them in their daily prayer life. It helps do those things. And what happens if they memorize it?
They get to write their name on the wall.
And
they get a button.
We have buttons. We still have buttons around here.
But they're closer to God. They're closer to understanding what he wants from them.
That's right.
And the relationship with him, which is the most important thing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So Angie, it's been a great series.
It's been a great series.
It's been a really, really, really good thing. Like we mentioned in the very beginning, we've learned a lot. But it's time to bring this one kind of to a close. It doesn't close. It continues
on. No, this is going to continue.
And it's going to lead into our very next series that I'm excited about.
Yes.
It's going to be a lot of fun. And this is going to be for the next four to five weeks.
We'll see after that.
And we actually gave a hint unknowingly.
We did, way back at the beginning.
At the beginning, because our next theme is?
It is all about Jesus.
It's all about Jesus.
All about Jesus.
That's right. And I'm excited for the next several weeks about what we're going to be bringing to the table on this. And
We're adding
someone with us.
That's right.
That's right. Yes. And it's, we're not going to tell them.
No.
You just got to wait and see. In fact, I may put like a little silhouette of the person right here.
Oh, there you go.
There you go.
There you go.
Can you guess who this person is? Yeah. So we'll see if they can guess out who it is.
Okay.
All right. So new series coming up. We look forward to it. Again, we want to thank you again for watching this series with us and hope that you take everything home with you. And remember, we should always remember what you should know, right? Mm-hmm. Because
you
know